Hey everybody, this is just going to be a quick video, just doing it off my phone while I'm driving at the moment, but this was a response to the my last edition of Your Questions, My Answers, and I had a lot of good questions. One of them in particular though, which I'm going to address right now, is somebody said, what are the negatives, if any, of van and RV life? And that's a tough one to really answer. You see, to some people, the negatives will be positives. To other people, the positives might be negatives. So I think that's really going to be up for perception, that each person is different. For example, some people would think that having to go and fill up your water every week and dump your tanks every week is a negative, all right? I see that as a positive, because that means I'm cut off from depending on somebody else. To give an example, I don't have to worry about paying utilities or the city water, the plumbing. I mean, in a way I am, because I still have to go and get hoses, and I'm connected to the city in that sense when I fill up my water tanks. But worst comes to worst, there's other ways to get water if you couldn't get any city water. And I'm working on a rain collection system, right? Another negative some people might see is not having constant 110 volt power on demand whenever you want. I, again, see that as a positive, because I'm generating my own power, so I'm not relying. Again, I'm not relying on anyone else. I'm not part of the grid. I provide for myself. I put the solar panels on my truck. I've got the deep cycle battery, and I only use what I need, and I don't overdo it. And quite frankly, it limits me too. Like, I can't sit on the computer all night and waste my life away like I was doing in my apartment a lot of the time. Because I wouldn't be able to do that. I wouldn't be able to power it all the time. And that's just fine with me. I like it like that. But you could set it up so that you have enough power to do that if you really wanted to. Again, so that's a positive for me. It might be a negative for somebody else. Some people don't like the idea of not having a place to go home to every night, like a location, a familiar place. They like the routines. I guess they've just grown up that way and they're used to it. A lot of people are afraid of change. They're in their comfort zone, in their bubbles. Whereas me, again, I see that as a positive. I actually don't like the feeling of being stuck in one place. I've said that God knows how many times on this channel. And I think I feel much more at home when I know that I can move it and I can be in a different place every day and have a different view out my window. So I don't feel trapped. I feel much more free. So again, there's a positive for me, maybe a negative for somebody else. But you see, the list can go on and on and on and on. But for my life in particular, if that question is directed just to me, what would the negatives be? I can't really say, man. There's just so many positives compared to apartment dwelling and living in houses with roommates and neighbors and having to worry about other people all the time. Not only worried about other people with noise and things like that, but also having to worry about or not having the ability to take ownership. I couldn't paint my walls if I wanted to. I couldn't install a fireplace on the wall if I wanted to. Can't even drill holes without permission. You can't even change the colors of the blinds if you don't have permission in a lot of buildings and stratas. And you're paying a lot of money to occupy space that you have no control over. Even if you own it, in a buildings like these apartment buildings I'm driving by right now, most people don't have freedom to do what they want to do with their space. And it's just, to me, that's the opposite of ownership. So that's the biggest positive change to me, is that I can do whatever I want with this. I can paint this van purple with zebra stripes if I want, all over the outside. I can drill holes in it. I can add and remove whatever I want, and I don't need anybody's permission except my own. So that is ultimate ownership, ultimate freedom, which is something lacking in society these days. Unless you go buy a piece of land out in the middle of absolutely nowhere, you can't do what you want to do with your own land even. So there's just, and all the other things I listed off too, so yeah, I'd say they're all big, big positives. I can't really see many negatives. I mean, I guess if you're slacking on watching your water levels and you wake up one morning and your toilet's full, oh crap, you're gonna have to drive to a dump station and dump it. You know, there's little things like that, but again, so what? Human beings used to live without all these modern luxuries, so to me, I see them as luxuries, not as necessities anyways. So it's nice to have them, and you get in a routine of maintaining them, and they just work differently than in a brick and mortar house, that's all. Just different type of maintenance, really. So yeah, hopefully that kind of answers your question, man. I forget your name off the top of my head because I'm driving and I couldn't look up the comment there, the name of the person who left that comment. But there you go, guys. All right. Keep on rocking the free world. We'll talk to y'all later.